So number one, I talk about the lesson of life in the story of Job. When the storm of life rages, when you are being tossed to and fro, not sure which way to go, Job realized that when bad things happen, it's not always a punishment from God. God might use you to glorify His name. Job chose to turn to God, and in the end, he realized that all things did work together for good. In the story of Gideon, we learn the lesson of battle. Even though when we are fighting a battle that we are being outnumbered, even though we are being drastically outnumbered, even though we are being surrounded by the enemy, the stake is high, the tide is rising, but Gideon realized that he only need the right position, he only need to stick with God's plan. All they have to do is to sit still and stand still and see the salvation of the Lord, because it's God can deliver every trouble, every battle you are fighting. And number three, we saw the lesson of prayer. The answer will come, but only in His time. All we have to do, again, is to stand still and let God move. But let's go back to Psalm number 46. Look at verse number 1. Psalm 46, verse 1. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore will not we fear, though the earth be removed, and though the mountains be carried into the midst of the sea. Verse number 10. Be still and know that I am God. You see, even though the earth be removed and the mountains be carried into the midst of the sea, maybe the waters raw, you know, the life is raging, the mountains shake with the swelling, but just be sure, there's never a moment where His hand is not stretched out. And because we have to realize that God is always good to us. Though my eyes can't see, help my heart believe, You are always only good. Because it is of the Lord's mercy that we are now consumed. Because His compassion fail not. They are new every morning. Great is Thy faithfulness. I love the lyrics of the hymn, Be Still My Soul. Be still my soul, the Lord is on thy side. Bear patiently the cross of grief or pain. Leave to thy God to order and provide. In every change, He faithful will remain. Be still my soul, thy best, thy heavenly friend. Through thorny ways leads to a joyful end. Be still my soul. When dearest friends depart, and all is darkened in the veil of tears, then shalt thou better know His love, His heart, who comes to soothe thy sorrow and thy fears. Be still my soul, thy Jesus can repay. From His own fullness, all He takes away. Be still my soul, the hour is hasting on, when we shall be forever with the Lord, when disappointment, grief, and fear are gone, sorrow forgot, love's purest joy is restored. Be still my soul, when change and tears are past, all safe and blessed we shall meet at last. You may ask what I'm preaching tonight. What I'm preaching is this. All you have to do to fight against the life's battle, to fight against the trials and tribulations, to have your prayer answered is to believe that God can work miracles, no matter how impossible that is. All you have to do is to believe that He is the God of the impossible. All you have to do is to stand still and let God move. Standing still may be hard to do. When you feel you have reached the end, He will make a way for you. All you have to do is to stand still and let God move.